Welcome back to The Witcher 3. It's time to finally and hopefully end the possession of Udalric. But before that, I've got 2 skill points to spend. So I spent a bit of time planning out exactly where I want to go with my character, and I'm going to make a bit of a change. So before I was simply dumping my points into Hunter Instinct, which increases critical hit damage against enemies that are a match to the kind of oil that I have on my blade, at least if you have maximum adrenaline points. And that's the key thing, if you have maximum adrenaline points. Now, I've been keeping a loose eye. To be honest, I haven't really been keeping that close of a watch at my adrenaline points, but I've been keeping a decent eye on my adrenaline points during combat, and most of the time when I stare up there, they don't seem to be maxed. So I've got a feeling that this skill is not actually getting triggered very often. So instead of dumping a bunch of points into a skill that's not going to get triggered very often, I'm going to make a little bit of a change, and I'm going to start spending my skill points into things that will generate more adrenaline. So the first thing I'm going to do is become a little bit more of a glass cannon. I'm going to dump Survival Instinct, which increases maximum vitality by 500. So I'm going to lose a bit of health. A bit of health is going to go away. Pretty good chunk, but I've still got 6,050 health left after that, and that's pretty damn good. So let's dump that, and let's get Adrenaline Burst. So that increases adrenaline generation by 5%, and using signs now generates adrenaline points. And I do use signs quite a bit. I mean, not a bunch of signs, but I use Quen quite a bit during combat. Really, pretty much all the time. So I'm hoping that will allow my adrenaline to increase a lot faster. So simply doing that should be pretty damn good already. That's going to increase the chance of Hunter Instinct actually doing something by quite a bit, I think. And, well, I guess the next thing I'm going to do is actually put more points into Hunter Instinct. But the change I'm going to make is that as soon as I unlock this slot, as soon as I reach level 26, as soon as I've got another slot, I'm going to start putting points into combat abilities. Which is going to be a first, because I have not put a single point into basic combat. Nowhere. But I'm going to start putting points into fast attack, I think. Or maybe fast attack and strong attack, or maybe fast attack and then like the next tier of fast attack. I'm not quite sure. But I'm going to fill up these last 2 slots here with combat abilities. And these general combat abilities that just increase the damage you do with your weapons, every single one of them, just like the alchemy, every single one of those increases your potion duration. Each one of these increases your adrenaline point gain by 1%. So by doing this, not only will I be doing more damage, but I'm also going to be getting more adrenaline. So between Adrenaline Burst here and the 2 combat abilities that are going to be in these slots, I should generate quite a bit more adrenaline. Yeah, so that's the plan. For now, just keep dumping points into Hunter Instinct, then as soon as this opens up, start putting some combat stuff in there. Okay, we've got a possession to exercise. Let's get that demon jogging. If I sing a hymn to the hymn, will that make it go away? You see what I did there? Was that a homonym? A hymn homonym? A hymnonym?
Child's cradle looks old. Must have been Udalric's knackers.
Looks like it's being used as a bucket for ethereal black goo.
An old cradle. Must have belonged to Udalric or Aki.
Yes, Geralt, that's what Saris just said.
As carrion crows haven't made their nests in the chimney.
Solid craftsmanship. Fitter must have been from the continent.
Geralt!
Hmm?
Geralt, come! Think I've got an idea!
Come up with anything?
Yes, I have a plan. One that just might work.
Can I get any details?
You've got to wait for me here. I won't be long.
Anything else?
Said yourself, you can't know the details. So no, nothing else. You simply gotta trust me.
Alright, she's gonna try the trick. She wants to try to trick the him. It's gonna be hard, but let's do it.
Hope you know what you're doing.
So do I. So, can we start?
I'm ready.
Alright, I'll be back soon. In the meantime, get a fire going in the oven.
Over there! She's running to the old house! Grab her!
Take him. You must put him in the oven. Trust me.
Take care not to hurt the child. Give me the babe.
In the oven. Throw him in the oven!
Seriously? Fine, I trust you. It's gotta be a trick, right? Ah, yes. Is the Quen protecting the baby? Please tell me it is protecting the baby, right? Right? I didn't actually just burn a baby alive, right? Right?
The Witcher committed no crime. You'll find neither despair nor guilt here. Only shock and relief. You've been tricked. You must go.
Wow, that actually worked.
It's over.
Over?
We tricked the Heim. It thought I'd killed your child, abandoned you to haunt me, feed on my conscience.
But when it saw the babe was whole, unharmed, it had to go. You're free, Jarl.
Free?
The Heim's gone. So are the voices that tortured you. Let's get out of here.
What's happening? My head's spinning. I'm spinning in a maelstrom.
Geralt, you said it was over.
That's just fatigue. In time, his mind will return to normal.
What? What will I do now?
You'll be fine. Key is to not give in to self-pity.
I feel as if someone's torn something from me.
That's normal. The Heim was a parasite. Bonds between parasites and hosts can be strong. That's why you feel empty now. Give it a few days, weeks, you'll be fine.
Thank you. I think. Farewell.
I'll go with him. He seems confused.
Good idea. Then what? What are your plans?
I'll stay a few days, make sure he's healthy. And you? Gonna stay on Speakerog?
Don't know yet. Gotta gather my thoughts.
I'm sure Yennefer must be growing impatient.
Thought we already discussed that.
We did. Farewell, Witcher. Favorable winds and following seas to you.
To you too. So long.
You know what I kinda wanna do? Is climb that mountain. New quest, King's Gambit, what's that? Oh, right. I was supposed to check on Ceres and make sure she's okay and help her if I can, and I've done exactly that. So I took a look at the quests before I started recording to see if there was anything else I wanted to do on this island, and I don't think there is. I think that's the end of it. Wait a minute. No. There's a quest to go to a cave around here, right? I thought I remember something about that. I don't think I checked contracts. Yeah! Britt mentioned the caves, that's right. Okay. Yeah, so there's still one thing left before we go. Okay. I do want to try to climb that mountain, though. And I'm gonna do exactly that. I'll be right back. Well, I tried coming around the back, and I got pretty dang close. That's the top of the mountain right up there. Got pretty close, but I couldn't do it. This last jump here, this area right here is just insurmountable. It was a good effort, though. Now we just need to get down. Let's go down this way. Time to do some sliding. Whee! I'm gonna stop myself here because I'd like to go over this ridge. Because over the ridge is the direction of the quest. Come on. Come on! Nope, I'm going all the way to the bottom. Okay. Come on, Geralt. There we go.
Faster.
And we've got a question mark somewhere really nearby. Yeah, right there. Just take a left in the road when it splits off. Bandits. Of course. Do I have Hangman's oil on? Yeah. Yeah, so I got to 2 adrenaline points during that fight. Still not happy with my adrenaline generation. I mean, that was a moderately sized fight. I guess a long fight against a boss would definitely generate enough adrenaline, but I'd like even common fights like this to generate enough to use that skill.
pathetic.
Interesting. Looks like that's it. Excuse me, goats. Necrophage oil time. Unless I've already got it on. No, I've got Spectre oil on.
Drowners couldn't possibly lift Nils into the air.
Armor's taking a beating. 50%. Let's fix that up.
Siren tracks. A very big siren.
Let's rest here for a second and get my stuff back. You know what? Let's also take Cat. It's kind of hard to see in here.
Strange scale color. Not your everyday siren. Strange scale color. Not your everyday siren.
This is a big cavern. One big enough for a siren to fly in. Explosive barrels.
Strange scale color. Not your everyday siren.
Jesus. Hard to see, but... looks like there's some nests.
Nils. Gotta be. Some monster dropped him from high up. Brit wasn't lying.
Okay, let's dump all potion effects, get rid of Cat. Echidna would be a hybrid, right? That's in with harpies and arenarias and sirens. It's gotta be. Right? It's gotta be. So, hybrid oil? What if my horn would work? Nope. Holy shit, that didn't even make it fall out of the sky. Okay. Probably gonna take art for that, I guess. that was weird, it just like froze in midair. Froze again. Hey, how you doing? Wakey wakey. That's it? That was the whole fight? See what that trophy is. 5% bonus gold? No thanks. Back to my 10% chance to dismember. I think that's it for Speaker Rog. Yeah, it's all the question marks, all the quests, as far as I can tell. Let's go back.
Come on, Roach.
Ooh, that is maybe not the way to go. This kind of looks like a trail. What the? That was weird. Okay, that's not gonna work. It should work. There we go. What are you doing up there, Roach? Come down. You're not a mountain goat.
Master Witcher?
Found an old echidna in a cave on the shore. Tough beast, but I killed it.
So Britt spoke true? A beast took Nils?
And killed him. Body's in the cave.
I'll have to fetch it. Witcher, would ye mind telling Britt what happened to her betrothed?
Fine. I'll talk to her. It's the least she deserves.
Feel like a damn fool now, not believing me own sis. Take this. Hard work deserves payment.
Farewell.
This is going to be a depressing conversation.
Need to talk to you.
Leave me be.
Your betrothed is dead. An echidna captured and killed him.
Nils.
This won't bring him back, I know. But I avenged him. Killed the beast.
Thank you. Knew all along he was true to me. And so I'll vow to be true to him for the rest of my days. Take this gold. It ain't much, but I want you to take it.
Thank you, but I won't accept any coin from you.
Why do you offend me so?
Don't take it the wrong way. There are things even a witcher shouldn't take coin for.
Alright, I think there's two more islands to set sail for, right? So I've done Unvik and I've done Speakerog. Yes, there's one more here. Whatever this island is called. Looks pretty small. But I'm sure there's a couple quests there. There's three question marks. And then the other one is down here. This one looks a little bit bigger. So which one should I go to next? Oh, you know what? Before I do anything else, let's get the diagrams from the lighthouse. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, so we've got a quest here. Oh, there's enemies, aren't there? Yep. Okay, so we have a treasure hunt for this place. Cat School Gear Upgrade Diagrams Part 1. Yeah, that's the one. Right? It is for here, right?
Don't quiver in your breeches as if Ragnarok were upon us. 'Tain't but a tower. We should assemble all warriors and go for glory, I tell you.
And disappear like the others.
Okay. Hey, we have arrived at the new place. Let me just catch you up on what happened. So I was looking for the diagrams for the next upgrades for the cat school gear at Eldberg Lighthouse. I thought it was strange that they were right at the fast travels, as if it was suggesting I should go somewhere else, but I'm not sure. But I took a look around and I found some stuff sunken in the water, but I didn't find anything for the quest. I didn't find any recipes for the next tier of cat school gear. So I'm not quite sure what's going on with that. And then I was looking at the map and I was looking up here, I'm like, oh, this is the next place I'm gonna go. And then I accidentally double-clicked on the fast travel, and I just fast-traveled here. So, hey, we've arrived! I didn't mean to, I meant to sail here, not fast travel, but what's done is done. So I just got a new quest just by appearing here. It's this, right? Yeah, the Tower Out of Nowheres. Level 30, ooh. I like high level quests. Wind whipped and rain battered, Geralt stumbled into a small village on the coast of Anskellig. The foul weather, he learned, had cursed this spot ever since a mysterious tower appeared one morning out of thin air, as if placed by an invisible giant's hand. Intrigued, Geralt decided to investigate. Whoa.
Storm, damn it.
My god. Now I really, really, really extra wish I sailed here. I'd like to see the weather suddenly turn horrible as you start coming over here. Is that... Oh my god! Not only have I seen double horses, I just saw a double cow. Although they just split, like sails dividing. So there's a tower on this island that has mysteriously appeared. Where? What tower? I don't actually see a tower.
Look.
What is it?
I got a job for you. There's no point standing here in the rain. All right, let's go to mine. We'll talk there.
So what's the matter?
You see that knoll beyond the village? Weren't a thing there for centuries. Till one day we awoke, bam! There were a tower atop it. Then all of a sudden lightning started pounding down. As if the Noggle Fir itself was sailing in. Hasn't stopped to this day. Something's gotta be done. About the storm. With waves like that, we can't fish nor sail out to raid.
You tried getting inside the tower?
Have we tried? Very same morn the tower appeared. We went right off. Whole village or nearabouts. Folk wanted to welcome its owner if he came in peace. Drive him off if he came with ill intent. We knocked and banged, but no one answered. So we opened the door. And that's when our knees turned to jelly.
Why?
Because beyond that door was something like a sheet of water. But standing upright. Never seen such a thing in my life. Druid said it were magic. Gathered five brave lads, and they all marched in. No sign of them since.
Fine. I'll look into the tower.
Once you're in, cast your eye around for the folk from our village. Our druid and five good lads. Ah, it'd be a bitter shame to lose them.
You have my word.
Hemdall, guide you.
Fascinating quest. A tower that just appeared one day. A magical tower. Is there a notice board on this island? Doesn't look like it. Let's go speak with some of the locals though, see if they have any quests for us. Oh, this is somebody's home. Whoops. I thought this was the tavern. Wrong door.
Yeah.
build your fortitude. Greetings, stranger. Have a drink with us.
What are you offering?
Some Gwent cards. I will take those. Doesn't want to buy any weapons. Fair enough.
Take care.
Excuse me. Armor Smith over here.
Hey.
Greetings. If you're in need of a weapon, I'd be glad to forge something for you.
Let me have a look.
Sell some garbage. Oh, and you don't have anything I want to buy, do you? Doesn't look like it. That's heavy armor, let's sell that. Oh, they ran out of money.
So long.
Blacksmith over here.
You hear that noise? That's Freyr grinding her teeth. Means war's a brewing. Time to sharpen our swords.
With Bran dead, who will lead you?
Don't need a king to stick it to the Black Ones. No reason to wait.
Show me what you have in.
No Gwent cards, of course. I don't think blacksmiths or armorsmiths ever had Gwent cards. Doesn't seem like it. Just want to go through the village a little bit more. Just make sure that really is the only quest here. Just the one about the tower. Huh. I guess so. Alright, let's go do it. I'm curious. I'm really, really curious. Look at that sun. So red. Whoa. It's a Cyclops. Time for some Mogroid oil. Is this game easy, or am I just really good? I can't tell. I've got this game on hard, but fights just end up so damn easy. Is the sun gone behind the clouds now? Yeah, it looks like it. Dang. Can hear the power coming from within. I feel like I'm going to encounter specters, so let's put some specter oil on. Oh, that's the water. The water they were talking about when you step inside, it's a portal. So people stepped into there and they never came back, huh?
A portal. Shit.
That's it. Just a portal. The rest of the tower is destroyed. Let's see what's inside. Oh, hey!
Portal closed. Looked smaller from the outside.
And
intruder detected. Cease your intrusion. Leave at once.
No thanks. I think I'll stay.
Failure to leave when summoned. Intruder neutralization commence.
Freaking security system. Alright, golem. Golems are elementas, which means elementa oil. Oh, crap. I'm out of Tawny Owl. Oh well. This is gonna be a long fight. I think I'm gonna have to rely on poisoning again. Please poison it. Please poison it. You are an elementor, right? How come you're not getting poisoned? Hold on. What is a golem? It's not a cursed one, is it? No. It's gotta be an elementa. Yeah, it definitely is. Elemental oil and dimeterium bombs. I do have it applied, right? Yeah, elemental oil. So I've just gotten really unlucky with the poisons. Well, this fight should definitely generate a lot of adrenaline. Be careful. One hit could very, very easily kill me. And I'm out of Tawny Owl, so I've got to be really slow on the Quins. This is gonna be a long freaking fight, my god. Yeah, I'm not getting any poisoning whatsoever for some reason. Well, I've got maximum adrenaline, so my critical strike should do a lot of damage. Critical hit damage 500 and something. Nice. Jesus! Oh, fuck. Okay. I can do this. There's no doubt I can do this. It's just gonna take a good, like, 10 minutes or so. And I also need to make sure I get my stuff back. Alright, that's gonna help a lot. Let's do this. I think I'm gonna cut it out though, because it's gonna be a pretty boring fight. And here we go there. Ooh. Jesus. Talk to the man trapped behind the magic barrier. That fight was long. That was really, really long. Just to give you an idea how long it is, my sword kind of like broke partway through the fight. Now it's down to 45%. And let me get my potions back here. Okay, how long does Enhanced Thunderbolt last for? Enhanced Thunderbolt lasts for 2.5 minutes. I used all 4 of my Enhanced Thunderbolts. And I still had to fight it for quite a few minutes after that, so that was like a 10 to 15 minute fight. Jesus.
Come here, please. Finally, someone's come to free me. And a famous witcher at that. Thank the gods. I'm damned lucky you happen to be in Kavir. Was it King Tancred who sent you, or the Society of Magic?
Neither.
And we're not in Kavir. We're in Skellige. Local folk hired me. See, your towers brought a massive storm to their island.
We're in... in Skellige. So we've teleported.
Oh, this is much worse than I thought.
Let me guess. You lost control of the golem. Imprisoned you here, then attacked me.
My, no, that's not it at all. The golems are but one of the tower's defenses. Part of its defensive regulatory magicon.
What?
A defensive system. Magic. Ensuring only the tower's owner will use it. When it detects an intruder, it locks down all the rooms, denies access.
And since neither of us is the tower's owner, the golem attacked me and you're stuck behind bars. How do we evade its other charming features?
We must deactivate the defensive regulatory magicon. The tower's prior owner wrote a treatise about removing such defenses. Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire.
There must be a copy in the tower. Find it, please. With it in hand, I can try to circumvent the security measures, send you home and take the tower back to Kavir.
Can I get some more information first?
Some folk from the village came in here, right?
Their remains lie beside the golem.
Ah.
They came in a few days past. I was surprised to see their garb. But it just never entered my mind we might be in Skellige. There were just a few, led by a druid. The tower warned them. They failed to heed.
Folk on Skellige usually laugh in the face of warnings. If the tower had asked nicely, then offered them a horn of mead, they might have left then. Seen my share of wonders, but a tower that teleports itself? That's something new.
This defensive regulatory magicon. I tried to access it. Must have heard. Initiated some evacuation sequence. That opened the portal and jettisoned us through to Skellige. This, in turn, naturally generated electromagnetic disturbances. Hence the storm.
Storm I promised to dispel.
Then you must find Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire.
You clearly know who I am. I don't even know your name.
Seago Bunce. Mage and sorcerer in residence at the court of Pont Vanis. This tower was to be my new home. Bought it at an auction, you see.
A tower at an auction?
It belonged to Gottfried Stamfeld, a mage of some renown. When he passed on, his heirs auctioned the edifice off. They were all wary, repulsed. None dared see what Uncle Godfrey kept in his coloured jars. If it was their contents that had stripped him of his sense of smell and taken his left eye. They put the tower on the block, along with all it contained. The price was unbeatable. I couldn't resist.
What a bargain. Bought a teleporting tower.
Right. Time to get out of here and send this tower home. Where do I look for Gottfried's treaties? Any ideas?
The library might be a logical place to start. The key should be in the laboratory.
Where's that?
As you enter the room opposite, you'll see the laboratory to your left. The library straight ahead. But remember, you're an intruder. The tower is certain to want to stop you, make things difficult at the least.
We'll see who breaks first.
Try to smash that barrier.
Osvayu, Iferin, Advigyat.
Wait. If you can cast a spell to get rid of that barrier, how come you can't cast a spell to get rid of your own barrier? Huh. Anyway, I hope I don't have to fight any more golems. Because every one of those fights is going to be another 10 to 15 minutes.
Golem probably greeted them too. Golem probably greeted them too.
Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end this episode. This is turning into quite the fascinating little adventure. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to see if I can put this tower back where it belongs.